I'm gonna say it's even shorter, just 65 to like 75.
1965.
Yes.
To 1970. Yeah.
1965.
It's like, wait a minute, how did Janet Jackson get to be older than me?
1965 to 1980. And then Generation Y, or those millennials, are 1980 through 2000. Now, some sources say it goes all the way 75 to 2000, because we'll see there's a lot of similarities in X and Y. So who in their office has heard people, maybe you've complained about those lazy entitled millennials?
Hey, I birthed a couple of them.
But I'm one of them.
I haven't seen
them.
Not all of them, though, Carrie.
So, yes. They were no. So who in here is a millennial? Okay, so there's four of us. So I actually just did a presentation with a group just on millennials, but today we're going to talk a little bit about all. But the first thing I like to point out is really millennials are no different than any generation in that we're all different, right? There's lazy baby boomers. There's entitled baby boomers. Same with X, same with Y. So yes, it can be true, but you have to remember to look at individuals. So first I like to talk about is respect, because this is the big thing we hear about millennials, right? They're just not respectful to us in the office, is what I hear from managers all the time. A lot of this comes up from that why question, right? Millennials are the ones that you tell them to do something and they say, well, why? And you explain why, and they say, well, why? And they ask and they ask, why did they do that?
We just want to know.
They want to understand. Why do they want to understand? They can do their job better, and they can sometimes innovate and make it more
easier. They see a picture than what we see.
If you don't understand why you're doing something, how can you make it better? You can't, right? So that's a lot of things that people find disrespectful, because they're questioning and they're not respecting my seniority or the years I've done it, and that's not what they're doing. They're just not getting it across correctly. So sometimes you have to coach those millennials and help them. Well, this is how you should approach that question a little better. But there's a great article that describes people's feelings on respect. Baby boomers were known, they respect their elders, right? They respect authority and seniority. Xers say they respect you, but they don't. And Generation Y, or millennials, will respect you if you respect them. So that's really important to talk about in your offices, in a group setting. It's not a bad thing for them to know. This is how the different generations see it. So that the boomer, the millennial, will understand, I need to respect my elder, and they'll respect me. And the boomer needs to understand, maybe that millennial, I'm not getting along with them because they don't feel I respect them. So that's really important. Work-life balance. Who feels like this is something millennials made up? Well, we're rare, because yes, most people are thinking that's a millennial thing, but actually studies show that every generation rates it at the same importance. So really, that's a unifying thing, and it's not a millennial, oh, they just want to have that work-life balance. Skill building. This is something that all generations value, but boomers and Y, millennials, they're actually more similar. That boomers and Y both see that constant development is very important in their careers. Where X's see it more as a mean to an end. They pick their goal and they say, okay, I need this to get there. Boomers and millennials think of it more, I just want to constantly learn. Loyalty to the employer. So we also hear, oh, those millennials just jump around, right? They're not going to stay. I'm not going to have that millennial for more than 2 years. Have y'all heard that?
It's true with Gen Xers, too.
If you treat us right, though.
It's also true with boomers, actually. Right now, the average life of an employee is 18 months across all generations. So, and why is that? Anybody have a guess?
Because the employers change some of the rules.
Exactly. Where's the employer's loyalty to the employee? There's not any, right? So that's the issue. So it is important for you and your business, and if you manage people, to do what you can, and those areas are development. Keep that development up for all generations, not just your young ones.
2 minutes.
I'm sorry?
2 minute warning.
Okay, thank you. And also, pay raises is the other thing. It's hard when you're a real successful high performer. What's your usual annual raise around? 5%?
Yeah.
If you're really lucky, right? That's a really good company. The average conservative estimate for when you change jobs is 10%. And that's a very conservative. So someone who switches jobs every 2 years over a 10-year span versus someone who stays with the same employer, that person who jumped is going to make 50%. So that's something you have to battle with the employment today. So what you can do is, again, focus on that development and give them feedback. Show your appreciation for your employees. So to kind of sum it all up, all generations want the same thing. They want to be given interesting work to do, rewarded on a basis of their contributions, and given a chance to work hard and get ahead. So it's no difference, but sometimes we butt heads, but the best way to do that, to overcome that, is to get everyone together and talk about those differences.